Gamna-Gandy bodies are benign siderotic nodules, also known as tobacco flecks or tobacco nodules. They occur in the spleen and they are caused by microhemorrhages, and the common causes are portal hypertension and sickle cell anemia. They are formed when the central arteriole in the splenic white pulp becomes occluded. This results in periarteriolar hemorrhage, and minerals are deposited, including iron and calcium, resulting in a granulomatous response with foreign body type giant cells and fibrosis, resulting in siderotic nodule formation. Although portal hypertension and sickle cell disease are the two conditions most frequently associated with the formation of Gamna-Gandy nodules, there are many other conditions that may cause them as well, including hemochromatosis and haemosiderosis, paroxysmal nocturnal hemoglobinuria, hemolytic anemia, idiopathic thrombocytopenic purpura, cardiac myxoma, lymphoma and leukemia, and they have been reported to occur with various carcinomas. Gamna-Gandy bodies may be visualized on ultrasound, CT scans and MRI, and grossly they are yellow-brown nodules, 3 to 4 millimeters in diameter, resembling tobacco flecks. This is an ultrasound scan of the spleen, and you can see multiple white spots, and these are Gamna-Gandy bodies. The histological features of Gamna-Gandy bodies include nodules of fibrous and elastic tissue, periarteriolar hemorrhage, haemosiderin deposition and dystrophic calcification, and formation of granulomas and foreign body type giant cells. At the centre of this picture is an arteriole, and surrounding this is a orangey-red halo, and this is an area of hemorrhage resulting in Gamna-Gandy body formation. And here is another Gamna-Gandy body. There is dense fibrosis, and also you can see that there is a brownish pigment deposited. This is haemosiderin. This Gamna-Gandy nodule shows very dense haemosiderin deposition, and when this is stained with Prussian blue in the Perls stain, it stains obviously blue. So the presence of Gamna-Gandy bodies in the spleen give a very nice clue as to what is going on in the rest of the body.